said he's been dealing with a little bit of an ankle injury, so I'm going to be interested to see if he's going to kick a lot or if Hernan Nan is able to actually get to the ankle attack, some sort of ankle lock or leg lock, and if that affects it, affects his ability to get out or escape. There's a lot on the line here today because of the previous grappling match. I've had the experience of this. I fought Nate Diaz, and we did a grappling match, and I lost by an advantage. And then we fought 5 years later, and I head kick knocked him out.
Let's see if history repeats itself. Her certainly swinging for the fences with rights and left, and that certainly disturbed Lee's equilibrium a little bit, although he's on his toes, backpedaling away, looks okay.
Her said he's going to come out and try and finish this in the first round because he knew that if he got it in the second round, into the finals, that he wanted to have as much energy as he possibly could.
Well, there's the big bonus of finishing a semi-final quickly, right? You're as fresh as can be for the final. That'll be on the minds of both fighters here. Swinging back fist from Lee. Didn't quite connect as solidly as he would have liked. Her with the takedown.
Very impressed with Lee right now on the scramble. He looked to hit a little switch. We'd call that a wrestling switch where you reach back and grab him in the inside of the thigh. Pushes him to the fence, came up on a double leg. Lee did, and now he's in the clinch doing some nice work with the knees.
This is a good contest.
Both of these guys are extremely strong. Lee looks really good with this pressure. He's got nice shoulder pressure underneath the chin. They're battling for head position right now, which is like a chess match in fighting.
Oh, good forehand from Lee, wasn't it?
Very nice punches.
Rubbing left hand from her in reply. Featherweight, so 145 pounds, that's around 65.8 kilos.
Both of them came out a little hard in the beginning of this, so they're kind of getting their breath right now. It's normal, it happens. The feeling out process is over, and now they're just catching their breath and looking ready to come in for big exchanges.
Oh, good swinging from Lee, and a good left hand from her, but he goes down, and Lee surely has finished it, and he has. Not even at the halfway mark in the first round.
Fight!
This fight is brought to you by Naga World, the best integrated business, leisure, and entertainment hub in Cambodia. Ugg comes out in the southpaw stance, presses that jab forward.
He's really throwing that jab out there. He's not really setting anything up with it, but he's definitely coming forward.
He's very upright, Ugg.
Yeah, he's got to tuck that chin down. There he goes a little bit. He's trying to set up everything like that. Nice thing with a single leg on Lee, but he gets easily defended off.
Oh.
I would think that Lee would want to keep this fight on his feet for just a bit. Really testing out Ung's stand-up.
Doesn't want to throw anything more than a single punch at the moment, Ung. Just a jab, one hook we've seen. No punches in bunches so far.
He's got that good in-and-out movement. While Ung is kind of looking a little bit flat-footed.
Some heavy blows in there, though.
Yeah, they are
kick. Rolling sound that just ricocheted around the indoor stadium.
Yeah, they are both thrown with some bad intentions. Ung's got surprisingly nice head movement.
Yeah, he got well out of the way of that right hand, didn't he?
Just hear those thunderous leg kicks thrown by Ung. I don't know what he's trying to set up with that jab. I'd like to see him follow it up with something. Maybe bring it over with that straight left hand. Maybe switching back to the orthodox stance.
Yeah, staying quite square on in that stance as well, isn't it? From the waist up. Oh, we've seen, let's respectfully say, better fighters than him try that and come unstuck.
I like the strategy, though. Came out in the southpaw stance, throwing the heavy right jab, and then switching it back up to going orthodox. Got to put a little bit of confusion into the young fighter, Lee.
Lee with that tremendous start to his professional career in the ONE Championship cage. A lot of hope for this guy to one day perhaps become a world champion. Nathan Ung standing in his way.
Even though Lee is the younger of the two fighters, he's actually the veteran with more time inside the cage
sure,
than Ung.
Yep. Quite a pronounced difference in height, isn't there? 10 centimeters we knew, but he's so upright, Nathan Ung, that with a big right hand there, comes from a long way down. And a knee to the ribcage, that tattooed ribcage.
You can just kind of see the inexperience in Ongun's stand-up. As he's throwing these punches, he's dropping the other hand, leaving it down. He just doesn't seem as comfortable as Li does and relaxed on his feet. But he's throwing heavy punches, which I like. He's probably doing some damage. He's definitely keeping Li moving backwards as well.
There's not many punches being flicked out here, are there? They're heavy, as you say.
You can just see the respect shown by each of these fighters. You know, they definitely want to take their time, get comfortable in there, and really see how the other one kind of responds.
More action, okay? More action.
Joey Lee Peaton gets in there and pushes the action as the crowd cheers him on here.
It's a good left jab. It was the windmill action of the right hand perhaps deceived Li for a moment, and that jab comes thundering in, doesn't it? And he's caught him consistently there.
Yeah, that jab is snapping Lee's head back, though.
Very fast, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
It's not in any way a rangefinder. That's a good left hand, though, from Li. The counter punch to that jab.
But he's got a good 10 centimeters in height.
Huge difference
on Li, so he's got to have that reach advantage. And he's really utilizing the jab quite well. He's not utilizing anything else, but he's definitely scoring points with the jab.
You're right, though. On paper, for the taller man, that's the most useful weapon to use, that jab. And it's been, I must account for 95% of his punches so far. Switches to southpaw again.
See, typically the jab is used to set up other attacks, but he is using that as his primary weapon.
Li just threw his head to the side there. Oh, and missed with a left and a right.
30 seconds.
And as Mitch picked up early on in the fight, Nathan Ung has some nice head work, evasive maneuvers.
There we go. Now he's starting to mix in the leg kicks, which I like. Now he's starting to get Li thinking about different attacks and coming from high and low ranges, which is great.
Oh, he heard it. Damn.
The referee stopped it.
Oh, what a thundering shot.
Right at the end of the round, my goodness.
Ed Uchiha comes forward early, long reach on the jab. Counter right hand there from Li Kai Wen.
Man, Michael, when I said these were two of the most exciting featherweights in ONE Championship, it was no exaggeration. These two cannot be involved in a boring match.
Overhand right from Li Kai Wen, but the mustard, the power isn't there as it was earlier. Jab again from Urrutia, cuts off the movement. Jab from the American. There's a right-hand counter from Li Kai Wen. Drifts back to center cage. These two martial artists have given it their all and some more. You hear the corner of Urrutia saying, walk him down. And that's what Urrutia is doing, continually coming forward. Beautiful jab, uppercut combination from the American.
I like that. He changed it up a little bit, split the guard with the uppercut. But Li Kai Wen, he's backing up, but he's starting to land as well.
Overhand right from Li Kai Wen. Oh, momentarily. Urrutia did the chicken dance. Can Li Kai Wen capitalize? Yes, he did.
Choke!
On the one fantasy game of the ONE Super Round. 73% tipping Li Kai Wen. He opens up like a house on fire. Li Kai Wen with an elbow on the inside. LeMahieu, he's going to have to rev up the early storm for the Chinese Warrior. High kick from LeMahieu. Li Kai Wen with a takedown. Top position for Li Kai Wen. The aggression early on from the Chinese athlete.
Nice top control position right here for Li Kai Wen. Let's see if he starts to go neck hunting. Looks for a choke. Looks like he's going darce. Cradles it up. Look at that lock on the leg. Oh, he's going to cradle the leg.
Li Kai Wen. Oh. And he finds another first round finish. He's at four of them in his career.
Look at him dragging LeMahieu around, trying to pop the top.
LeMahieu in trouble. Li Kai Wen wants to take it home.
Bring it.
LeMahieu, 72% finishing rate. Li Kai Wen, 67% finishing rate.
see Li Kai Wen switching stances, trying to protect that knee, but he just can't help it. He has to go back to orthodox to let that thunderous right hand start to go.
LeMay here has two first round finishes. He is 0-1 against Chinese opponents. Turning back here. Look down there from Li Kai Wen.
LeMay trying to use some of that black belt and taekwondo skills that he's got. Li Kai Wen just keeps closing that distance, and LeMay is going to get caught with his chin up in the air.
Going for the headache maker, Li Kai Wen. Short right hand, hooking punch to the jaw from Li Kai Wen. He began his martial arts career in Kung Fu under his father. Began wrestling as an 8-year-old. Round kick from Lemahe.
I'll be wondering about the gas tank. That was a frantic 2 minutes right there. Who's got the juice left? Nice little popping left hand there from Li Kai Wen. He keeps lunging in with that left. Touch it, Lemahe. Lemahe's got to be careful to keep that chin nice and tight to his chest.
Li Kai Wen comes in 3 wins in a row, including 2 in the first round. Lemahe's got 3-2 in his last 5. Back-to-back losses to Sonoto and Ji Kang Zhang. Points out quick to knees from Li Kai Wen, the meet and greet. Lemahe turns him around, but Lemahe looks tired. The hands are dragging low. Here comes Li Kai Wen. He plays up. Li Kai Wen bounds out of his corner in southpaw stance, the orthodox stance on Rodian Menchavez.
Menchavez has got to use the jab.
Keep the big kick off! And score!
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.